Have you ever felt trapped in a relationship that seems more harmful than beneficial? Today, we're discussing an intriguing psychological concept known as trauma bonding. It's an intense emotional tie between an abused individual and their abuser, forged within the cyclical nature of violence. Imagine a bond so powerful that it keeps you tethered to the source of your pain. It's a complex, confusing, and often invisible struggle. Let's delve into the 8 signs that signal you might be in a trauma bond rather than a loving relationship. The first sign is extreme emotional intensity. Trauma bonds are marked by a whirlwind of emotions, swinging from the heights of love to the depths of hate. This intensity is often mistaken for passion, but genuine love is stable and calm, not a tumultuous storm. If your relationship feels like a never-ending battle, a tug of war of feelings that leaves you exhausted, it's time to pause. If you're constantly on an emotional roller coaster, you might be in a trauma bond. The second sign is misplaced loyalty. This manifests when victims of trauma bonding remain loyal to their abusers, despite the harm inflicted upon them. It's a striking demonstration of the skewed power dynamic within the relationship, where loyalty becomes a tool used for control and manipulation. This loyalty, often born out of fear and confusion, is directed towards someone who consistently causes pain rather than reciprocating with care and respect. Loyalty should be a two-way street, not a one-way path to pain. The third sign is an inability to detach. This is a critical hallmark of trauma bonds. Despite recognizing the harm the relationship is causing, victims often find it incredibly difficult to break free. Like an invisible tether, the bond pulls them back time and again. It's not a mere lack of willpower, but a deeply ingrained psychological response to the cycle of abuse. They are ensnared in a toxic dance, struggling to find the exit. Just remember, love shouldn't make you feel trapped. The fourth sign is a repeated cycle of abuse. This cycle is a powerful and destructive pattern that can characterize trauma bonds. It starts with periods of intense abuse, followed by reconciliation, where the abuser may apologize profusely, promising it won't happen again. But then the abuse resumes, setting the stage for further reconciliation. This cycle becomes so ingrained that it becomes difficult to break, trapping the victim in a relentless loop. Remember, love isn't about cycles of harm and forgiveness. The fifth sign is rationalizing abuse. It's a common yet, heartbreaking pattern where victims of trauma bonds may downplay the severity of the abusive behavior. They might find ways to justify it, or even worse, blame themselves for the mistreatment they're enduring. This self-blame is often a result of manipulation and control tactics used by the abuser. It's crucial to recognize this pattern and understand its roots in manipulation, not in truth. Remember, abuse is never your fault. And the sixth sign is feeling stuck. This is a common sensation experienced by victims of trauma bonding. They often feel as if they're caught between a rock and a hard place, unable to live with their abuser due to the pain and suffering, yet feeling they can't live without them either. This sense of entrapment can be overwhelming, creating a vicious cycle of dependency and despair. In a healthy relationship, love should be a catalyst for growth and progress, not a force that leaves one feeling stuck. Love should be about growth, not feeling stuck. The seventh sign is fear of retribution. This fear is a powerful trap, often leading victims to believe that leaving the abuser will result in dire consequences. This could be anything from physical harm to the threat of isolation. It's a crippling cycle that further strengthens the trauma bond, making it even more difficult to break free. This fear isn't a testament to a strong relationship, rather a glaring red flag of a trauma bond. Remember, love should bring peace, not fear. The eighth and final sign is loss of personal identity. This can occur when victims of trauma bonding become so wrapped up in their abuser's world that their own sense of self begins to fade. Their interests, dreams, and even their personal values can become overshadowed by the manipulators. It's like they're living someone else's life, not their own. This is not love. Love should respect and appreciate your individuality. It should make you feel more like yourself than ever before. Love should enhance your identity, not erase it. These signs are all indicative of a trauma bond, not a healthy, loving relationship. Trauma bonds are characterized by extreme emotional intensity, misplaced loyalty, inability to detach, a repeated cycle of abuse, rationalizing abuse, feeling stuck, fear of retribution, and a loss of personal identity. It's crucial to distinguish these signs from the hallmarks of a healthy relationship: mutual respect, empathy, and kindness. Remember, you deserve love and respect, and there is help available if you find yourself in a trauma bond.